We're gonna skate to one song only.
We have before us the opportunity to forge for ourselves and for future generations a new world order. A world where the rule of law, not the law of the jungle, governs the conduct of nations. When we are successful, and we will be, we have a real chance at this new world order.
And people talk then, in 1990, of the New World Order.
What is at stake is more than one small country. It is a big idea. A New World Order.
But what does the New World Order mean for countries like ours?
But the burden of global citizenship continues to bind us together.
What I believe is our destiny of success in this New World Order.
What do you think the most important thing is for Barack Obama?
I think his task will be to develop an overall strategy for America in this period when really a new world order can be created.
We've got to give them a stake in creating the kind of world order that I think all of us would like to see.
So, in conclusion, ladies and gentlemen, a new world is emerging. It is a new world order with significantly different and radically new challenges for the future.
The time for our leadership is now. It was the United States and the United Kingdom and our democratic allies that shaped a world in which new nations could emerge and individuals could thrive. And even as more nations take on the responsibilities of global leadership, our alliance will remain indispensable to the goal of a century that is more peaceful, more prosperous, and more just. The nature of our leadership will need to change with the times.
Receive this honor with deep gratitude and great humility. It's an award that speaks to our highest aspirations. For all the cruelty and hardship of our world, we are not mere prisoners of fate. And yet I would be remiss if I did not acknowledge the considerable controversy that your generous decision has generated. In part, this is because I am at the beginning and not the end of my labors on the world stage. Compared to some of the giants of history who have received this prize, Schweitzer, King, Marshall, and Mandela, my accomplishments are slight.
You just said some. You used the phrase "a Muslim president."
And right.
There are a lot of our viewers out there who have probably jumped up straight up on their chairs and said, "What did he say?"
Yeah.
And why do you say that?
And I will give you the reason. My wife Rachel is Jewish and I'm Jewish, but I'm from America. She's from Egypt. I think like a Christian. She thinks like a Muslim. My wife is an intelligence gatherer for the Israeli government and plays radio. And she was picking up broadcasts for years before the 2008 election. And the Saudis were saying, and my wife didn't understand it until later, we will have a Muslim in the White House in 2008. And the fact is, nobody knew who Obama was before 2008.
That's true.
And he became a senator, I believe, in 2006. He barely served a very short time as senator, and all of a sudden he becomes the president of the United States.
President to the United States faithfully.
And I will execute
the faithfully the best office of president of the United States.
The president of the United States faithfully.
In my country. Assalamu alaikum. Candidate for president, but as a citizen. A proud citizen of the United States. And a fellow citizen of the world. But the burdens of global citizenship continue to bind us together. A change of leadership in Washington will not lift this burden. In this new century, Americans and Europeans alike will be required to do more, not less. Partnership and cooperation among nations is not a choice. It is the only way. The one way to protect our common security and advance our common humanity. The walls between races and tribes, natives and immigrants, Christians and Muslims and Jews cannot stand. These now are the walls we must tear down.
President Obama has committed 30,000 more troops to Afghanistan, but has also announced a withdrawal could begin as early as the middle of 2011. Some in the U.S. are skeptical Obama's new strategy will work. RT's Anastasia Churkina reports.
After months of making up his mind, the U.S. president has revealed his plan for Afghanistan, escalating the war at the fastest possible pace.
It is in our vital national interest to send an additional 30,000 U.S. troops to Afghanistan.
Photo call with the leaders last night. President Obama shook hands with Libya's Colonel Gaddafi. There's been hostility between the two countries for years over Libya's support for terrorist groups.
Today, the government of Libya announced the death of Muammar Gaddafi. This marks the end of a long and painful chapter for the people of Libya. We now have the opportunity to determine their own destiny in a new and democratic Libya. My fellow Americans, we gather during a historic anniversary. Last year at this time, in fact on this very weekend, we finally delivered justice to one of the world's most notorious individuals. We gather in the midst of a heated election season, and Axelrod tells me I should never miss a chance to reintroduce myself to the American people. Tonight, this is how I'd like to begin. My name is Barack Obama. My mother was born in Kansas. My father was born in Kenya. And I was born, of course, in Hawaii. In my first term, we ended the war in Iraq. In my second term, I will win the war on Christmas. I will win the war on Christmas.
We're gonna skate to one song only.